It's happened, guys. For the first time in over 2 years, the Astralis era, the Astralis five-man roster we have come to know and love and see succeed, have a bit of a roller coaster as well, but, you know, even as of late, Road to Rio Europe show, they are still one of, if not the best teams in the entire world, has officially changed their starting roster. That being Gla1ve announcing officially he is taking a step back and not quitting, but taking a break from CSGO. A lengthy break at that, that being at least 3 months from the roster. You get a fill-in for his space as well. If you guys remember, Nell said this a while back. Apparently, Magus was actually practicing the IGL role to fill in for that on the team as well. And this is crazy. Obviously, what Gla1ve refers to as the toughest decision of his entire life is a big one that we are now seeing of a top roster out there officially having one of, you know, the top players in the world take a step back, and following Kierby doing so, and of course I'm going to reference Nell's tweet as well. We have seen this time and time again with several pro players out there, whether it be physically, mentally, motivation-wise, or other reasons, taking steps back from CSGO. And of course, most recently, Alex from Vitality, over 200 plus days of travel every single year with that roster. He has now taken a break from CS himself, and then Kierby, and now this. This is crazy. As Gla1ve goes on to state, for a longer period of time, I've had symptoms of stress and burnout. My teammates in the Astralis organization have tried many different things to help me out and overcome this. As it's still going on, my doctor and I have decided that I need a break, and yesterday I've given a sick note to Astralis. The next 3 months, I'll be using my time to fully rest and then come back to the Astralis team. I want to say a huge thank you to my teammates in the organization for being so understanding and helpful throughout a situation like this. It can be tough to put health first, but I have found out that it's necessary. And by golly, it makes you ask so many questions. Is this coming for other teams out there? What does it mean for the seven-man roster of Astralis? Has that situation just been kind of, you know, shot? We thought this was going to be a seven-man rotating active roster, although I think a lot of us thought as well it'd be the solid five-man core when it comes to the actual major and the big events. I don't know what kind of wrench this throws in the entire plan. As of this morning, Yugi is already playing for the team. I believe the first map, a bit of a struggle. Second map, bounced back very well at the point of me recording. So Yugi doing what he can to fill in with one of the best rosters in the entire world. What the Astralis future plan is? Do they go 8-man? Do they go eventually 9, 10-man, like we have heard rumors and seen them talk about 2 players per role? Or is this just an ultimate plan to try and fight burnout with cash, to fight burnout with additional players? Will we see other teams out there also add 6, maybe 7 men? So if one of their guys goes, hey, I'm feeling iffy, give me 3 months off, reduce my salary, fill someone in, we can only speculate right now. But the fact is this: we have a top player on a top team out there now also having health or whatever it might be issues when it comes time for a strenuous CS schedule, traveling probably 35 plus weeks of the year, or at least competing as much, and it's taking a toll. Who is next, right? This is crazy, crazy times, guys. The Astralis roster that we have seen achieve so much is now officially no longer. Best of luck to Gla1ve, of course, in his recovery. In 3 months, we will see him back, and we will see exactly what this roster does in his absence. Until next time, hope you guys all enjoy tons of CS topics coming on this channel, okay? I'm not done yet. We got a lot to talk about. Until next time, you know what to do. Keep it real, stay cool, be nice. I'll see you guys back here sometime soon.